This video from a Florida sheriff shows a young man police say was hallucinating on a chemical drug. They're sure he took bath salts, powders that aren't really for your bath. Police in Vermont say they're becoming more and more of a problem here, sometimes turning users violent or delusional, even causing kidney and heart failure.
We want to stay ahead of the curve. We want to understand what it is.
Winooski Police Chief Steve McQueen was one of several in Vermont law enforcement who came to the State House Thursday to learn more about the synthetic stimulants. They go by a bunch of street names and are often labeled with colorful slogans that make them appear harmless.
Here we go. Thank you, Governor.
Vermont Governor Peter Shumlin had already joined most states in banning the substances. But the problem is, manufacturers have just been changing formulations to skirt the rules.
And when you use them, you're literally being a guinea pig for these manufacturers because they don't know. They've never tested them on anybody.
So Central Vermont Medical Center ER Chief Dr. Mark Detman is glad Vermont is now adding dozens more designer drug ingredients to its already long list of illegal compounds.
Just this week, state police announced Vermont's first bath salts death, saying 28-year-old Chris Tescoins of Clarendon OD'd on the chemical drugs back in June.
Bath salts are bad news. They're killing Vermonters. They are poison.
And Governor Shumlin revealed Thursday that bath salt ingredients are now believed to be a contributing factor into a horrific wreck on Interstate 89 in May. A driver crossed the median and crashed into oncoming traffic. The driver, his passenger, and an infant in the back seat were killed. Shumlin and local police hope their even tougher stance will block the sale of bath salts and convince Vermonters to never go looking for them.
They will hurt you. They will kill you.
In Montpelier, Jack Thurston, News Channel 5.